Hi everyone, my name is Robert Rooderkerk. I'm an Associate Professor of Operations Management at the Rotterdam School of Management, Erasmus University. And besides the many roles that I fulfill here on campus, I'm also the Academic Director of an exciting new master program, Business Analytics and Management. Right, let's see what the students answered to the question. Let's see if they've passed the test.
Hello, my name is Haley. I'm 19 years old, Vietnamese and second year IBA student.
Nice to meet you. My name is Tamás. I am a master's student. I'm from Hungary and I study business analytics and management.
Okay, nice. Shall we start?
Sure, let's go. Okay.
First and the shortest. So, who is this master for? Well, I think it will be for like bachelor graduates who are like, they can be business students who are interested in data, like analytics of course, and also maybe on the other hand like engineer students who are interested in the business prospect. Is that right?
Yeah, that's more or less correct, I would say. Yeah, well, basically business students with an affection with data and that are not really afraid of statistics and maths, you know. And on the other hand, as you said, engineers who are really interested in the business side but also they don't want to forget all about the maths and still do analytics in their work.
Yeah. Nice.
Well, I think they nailed this one. Indeed, we have two audiences in mind for this program. I think the first one is indeed students with a business bachelor or business master background who are not deterred by statistics and mathematics and who kind of grew a liking for data and working with data. But the second group, I think, is slightly wider than they say. It's not just engineers, but I think it could also be a student with a degree in physics or chemistry, a rocket scientist for that matter. So anyone that does a hard science, but somehow along the way discovered that they found business quite interesting and realized that there's a lot of rocket science you can do in business. So, good one. Let's go to the next question.
The second question. What is the teaching format? I want to go through the curriculum and I think it will be a 12-month program. And you will, like, in the spring semester, you have a business workshop, and also you have to do an internship with your thesis with some electives to choose from. Is that correct?
Yeah, more or less. Actually, it's very, very quite close to it. Well, we have six blocks, and one block is around 7 to 8 weeks long, and in each block we have three or four classes that we take. Most of them have a tutorial element, so we do practical exercises as well, mostly with R programming, and then as you said that we do have a thesis which has an internship option. You don't necessarily have to do an internship, but it's very much encouraged to do so. Yeah.
Well, this one's pretty close to how I see it as well. So I think if you look at the program, right, there's kind of five blocks in there. In the first block, you basically get submerged into all the building blocks that you need for analytics, statistics, programming, database management. Then the second block, the second period of 7-8 weeks, is going to be more about business domain knowledge. So you take a couple of business electives, but next to that, you also have two more analytics-oriented courses, management science and machine learning and learning algorithms. Then in January, so right after the Christmas break, we start with a business analytics workshop. That's a 4-week, 5-week, very condensed deep dive where you work with companies on solving a problem for that company and presenting the results to the company, where we really try to imitate what an analyst would do in you know, real life. And then indeed, the last two blocks are electives, where you choose one elective per block and writing your thesis, which can be done internally, but indeed, we stimulate you to do that at a company or a public organization. And that seems to be quite doable if I look at the past 2 years. All right, so let's go to the next one.
Okay. Let's do this one. Can I combine work with this program? I suppose yes, but can you give your answer?
This is something that probably program management would not be happy about doing. They don't really encourage it, and I would say it's not really a good idea because of the heavy workload that we have. So, I mean, technically you can do it because we have, I think, 1 day a week where we don't have any classes or so, but it would be very difficult to manage both, you know, work life and academic life. So probably just would not do it, you know.
Yeah, but it will like 100% about time management,
right? It is. Yeah.
All right, so looks like Tamás was drilled very well by us. No, I think it's indeed quite hard to combine this with a job. I think this is one of the most strenuous master programs at RSM, and I mean that in a good way. I think this is going to be a year that is going to feel like a, in a positive way, like you're going to hit the ground running. It's a very high-paced program, right? Because analytics, we have to teach you a lot to become an analyst. And it's really a year in which you invest in yourself, but it's going to pay off immediately already in the spring term, where you're going to look when you're going to start your internship, because those internships are typically also paid. So that's actually a way also to earn some money next to your study. I do obviously understand that some of you have restrictions in that sense, but I have to be honest here. I think especially the first two blocks are such high pace that I think it would be ill advised to do some work next to that. But obviously there's heterogeneity between you, but it's not something I would encourage. And I think this is a worthy investment. I think everyone that I spoke at the last graduation said this year was incredibly challenging, but it was also the best year of my life. I learned a lot, and it shows. I just started a job, and it looks like I'm incredibly well prepared for it. So I think that's what we take to heart. All right, let's look at the next one. Yeah.
Yes. Next question. What are the career prospects? Well, let me guess. It will be like data analyst, data science, or like any kind of job with the word analyst.
Kind of, yeah, true. You can either become a supply chain analyst, because we do have supply chain courses, or finance analyst. Data analyst is very common as well. Data scientist as well, if you're very interested in deep diving in machine learning, for example. Or business analyst is also a common job that people take when they combine it with IT, of course.
Yeah, so yeah. It's like a lot that you can do.
Yeah, there is a lot of opportunities for sure.
Yeah, I think this is also a pretty good answer. I think this master sets you up to basically help any organization improve on their business using analytics, and that can be a very wide domain, right? We have supply chain, marketing, finance, accounting, but there's also, of course, non-public, right? So we've had students that graduated at ministries that, for instance, use machine learning to detect fraud in tax forms. So the world is really at your feet when you finish this program. You are very highly sought after. And indeed, the titles range from analyst, where you're more a connector between the hard data scientist and the problem owners. Data scientist, where you are that person that's really deep diving and conducting analysis. And it can sometimes have, you know, a wide variety of terms that you can have, analyst, analytics, scientist, or whatever you name it. But I tend to say that the positions that you start are at advanced entry positions. And what I mean by that is you will not typically start as a junior data scientist, but you typically have more skills than that. And so it's like an advanced junior position that you typically end up starting with. That's if I look at the current cohort, the first cohort that graduated, they all have really good positions at companies such as Tesla, ABN, Dutch omnichannel retailer Coolblue, Philips, so a wide range of companies in different industries. So I think it's a correct answer.
What makes this master at RSM unique? Well, I think I cannot have any guess for this. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think it's unique because it's one of the masters that is the most practical at RSM. I think they introduced it a year ago, so we are the second cohort. And I think the aim was that they recognized the need for analytical prospects as well for business students. And that's why it's unique, because we have a lot of technical skills that we also learn next to the business skills.
Yeah, I think it's definitely true. I think this is a very unique master program. I think, first of all, when we set this up, we actively talked to companies and organizations. How are your current analytics people conducting their work? What skills do they need? How do you work, right? So one thing that you see in practice is that people work in very rapid iterations, right? So we build something, we test it, we improve it, and we go on. So we don't like wait for 5-6 months and then unleash the new solution. No, we try it, we build it, we test it, it doesn't work, we improve it. And that mindset is something that we also try to mimic in the master program. So if you will, we've looked at how practices reverse engineered our program to make sure that we train you in all the facets that are needed to do that job in practice. And I think that's very unique. That's the first unique element. The second unique element is, I think, that all the faculty members are teaching in this program are not just conducting research in this domain, they're typically moving the needle on research. They're on the forefront of the research. RSM is a top business school in Europe, and the faculty that teach within this program are really, really excellent. They are the three-legged people. They're excellent in research, they're excellent in teaching, the teaching evaluations are stellar, but they're also people that talk to companies and work with actual companies, work with data, so you'll see a lot of that in the program. So it's really, really a unique program. And I think the testimony to that is that a lot of universities in Europe are currently asking us about our experiences and for advice on starting up their analytics program. So it's really something I'm very proud of.
Okay, let's go for a long question. So how much does the program focus on business analytics and management? You should go.
I think, well, most of our courses in the beginning were more about analytics. For example, we had advanced statistics, where we very deep dived into all of the statistical techniques that you can use. Or right now, we also do machine learning, which is also heavily technical. But on the same time, we also have management-related courses, for example, marketing or supply chain or finance, where we actually apply these analytical techniques in management problems. So I think it's a mix of the two. Nowadays it was mostly analytics, but I think you can also go more in depth in the management side as well.
Yeah, so it's really designed to serve like what the society will need. Yeah, because it will cover all of the concepts.
Yeah, more or less like that. And also what you are interested in, you know, because we have electives, and if you're not interested in finance, you don't have to take finance. You can also go for supply chain, for example.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
these are also really good answers. I think, like I said before, I think analytics, we're teaching business analytics, not analytics. So it's always connected to business, right? We're teaching you techniques that can be used to solve business problems. We start with much more analytics-oriented courses. The first five courses are really analytics, so optimization, causal inference, experimentation, data management. But I would say as of block two, where you start following the electives, it's always business and analytics together. I think another important remark that's made here in the video is that you have some room to choose, right? I think what is nice about this program is that in the end of the program, you will have been exposed to at least two different business disciplines. Now, there's a variety of instructors from different courses, so you will be exposed to all of them in some way. But you get the chance to specialize yourself, and there will always be at least more than one area of specialization. So let's say finance and accounting, finance and marketing, marketing and supply chain. And that's kind of really neat, I think, because you both have this kind of wide tool set that everyone needs, and then the ability to do specialization in the area that you like. And you'll discover what you like in the first two blocks, and then you can specialize more in the electives in the spring and by choosing your internship. So I think that's correct. Next one.
Okay, so this is the longest one. Let's go. How does this master compare to RSM's Business Information Management program? I think this is one of the most popular questions that prospective students would care about. So can you elaborate on this?
Yeah, it's true. I get this question a lot, honestly. And when I was joining BAM, I had the same question, you know? And after, I think, 1 year, I kind of figured out that the difference is mostly about the approach that we have towards IT. So while business information management really focuses on how to create an IT strategy for a company, in our case, in BAM, we mostly focus on how to get information out of data and how to analyze this data to create business value. So I think that the difference is mostly we are more technical and they are more business involved than we are. Yes.
Yeah. BIM versus BAM. The question that's on everyone's lips. I guess I was always joking that if we also have a behavioral operations master, we have BIM, BAM, and BOM, which makes it more complicated. But where does BAM differ from BIM? I think in business information management, indeed, there's more emphasis on the information systems side to it, right? So how do you organize data within your organization? Information systems, also things like auctions that are tied to that. Those are topics that we don't really look into. They also do some analytics, but we do more analytics and we take a much deeper dive, I think. So if I compare also internships, I think in BIM I see applications of data science, and I think in our case I see more cutting edge applications of data science. People really extend data science techniques. I think the other thing is, the other aspect to it is that our master is much more multidisciplinary. I think the focus in BIM is very much on the marketing and on the smart city concepts. That's really the expertise of that faculty teaching in a program. And I think here we have also the finance and accounting angle, the supply chain angle, which are typically really missing from the BIM. So I think BIM is much at a higher level, whereas data science is much more at a deeper level. So I think those are nuances between those two programs. Also an excellent master program. So in that sense, there is not a bad choice. Let's look at what I believe is going to be the last question.
And the last one. Is it true that business analytics and management graduates are in high demand? Do you think so?
I hope so. That's why I also joined for this master. But you know, that's something that I always say, that data science is the sexiest job of the 21st century. So I really hope that's true. And well, actually, you can kind of see that in the job market as well, that most of the skills or most of the jobs do require some technical skills, and we definitely do learn about those. So I think this is a true statement.
Yeah, the sexiest job. I don't know about that. That's I don't want to burn my fingers on that one, but it's definitely one that is in incredibly high need. I talk to a lot of companies, and a lot of those companies tell us, can you give me another 10? Or in certain organizations such as Philips or Coolblue, can you give us another 100? There is a very high need in business for data analytics people, business analytics people. Why is that need there? First of all, because in a lot of sectors, competition has increased a lot. Nowadays, with online, with new business models, take flash couriers, right, that deliver your groceries in 10 minutes. The one that's gonna win is gonna be the one that uses the data the most efficiently. It has the deepest pockets, I guess. But gaining a competitive advantage through analytics is not only essential, it may even be essential to survival of a company. Currently at LinkedIn, you do a search with something like data science or business analytics in it, you see that there's currently around 3,000 vacancies just in the Netherlands. In Europe, it's currently, factoring in at close to 100,000, which is the job title that has the one of the largest numbers of outstanding vacancies. And this includes a lot of organizations. So this can be startups, established companies, right? So CPG, the Unilevers, the Procter & Gambles, the Philips of this world, but also emerging companies that come from far and near. So you will be really well positioned when you go out on the job market. And I think you have a lot of freedom to choose what you want to do. I hope this was informative. Good luck with making your decision. And I hope to see you in Rotterdam.
Thank you.